conversation continues now with the darker side of science fiction, the world of nightmares. These strange worlds are the stage for two of the most innovative programs ever created, Twilight Zone and The Prisoner. Rod Serling created The Twilight Zone in 1959, and every Friday night for 5 years we gained entrance into this macabre world. A horrifying place where nightmares lurk behind closed doors. A door that is unlocked with the key of imagination. Beyond it,
a dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Unforgettable images like these were a mainstay on the Twilight Zone. A never-ending stream of imaginative visions and chilling fantasies.
Won't somebody take a lamp or a bottle or something and end this?
You, Mr. Bemis, are a reader.
A reader?
A reader. A reader of books. Magazines, periodicals, newspapers. I see you constantly going downstairs into the vault during your lunch hour.
Books! All the books I'll need. All the books. All the books I'll ever want. Shelley, Shakespeare, Shaw, all the books I want. Time. Ah, there's time enough at last. There was time now. There was all the time I needed. That's not fair. That's not fair.
There's a man out there.
What?
Look! Look, he's crawling on...
Yes, Mr. Wilson? Can I help you, Mr. Wilson?
I know I had a mental breakdown. I know I had it in an airplane. I know it looks to you as if the same thing's happening again, but it isn't.
Hurry! Hurry! He's out there!
What's going on?
He's pulling up one of the cowling planes.
Way of trying to commit suicide I ever heard of.
It's all right now, darling.
I know. But I'm the only one who does know. Right now.
The temperature stood at 110 degrees at 11 o'clock this morning. Humidity, 91%. Forecast for tomorrow, hot.
There was a scientist on the radio this morning. He said that it'll get a lot hotter, more each day, now that we're moving so close to the sun.
You know, Mrs. Bronson, I keep getting this crazy thought. This crazy thought that I'm going to wake up and none of this will have happened. I'll wake up in a cool bed. It'll be night outside. And there'll be a wind. Branches rustling.
As hot as it is, it could be so much worse. Oh, Norma, it could be so much worse.
A very high fever, but I think it's broken now.
Fever?
I wish I had something left to give her, but the medicine's pretty much all gone now.
Oh, there was a scientist on the radio this morning. He was trying to explain what happened, how the Earth had changed its orbit and was starting to move away from the sun, and that within 1, 2, or maybe 3 weeks at the most, there wouldn't be any more sun. We'd all freeze.
Isn't it wonderful to have darkness, coolness.
Yes, my dear. It's wonderful.
Some of the Twilight Zone's most surreal nightmares were thinly veiled explorations of very real social issues. We look now at perhaps the most acclaimed Twilight Zone of all time, the episode, Eye of the Beholder.
When will they take the bandages off? How long, nurse?
Until they decide whether or not they can fix your face.
Doctor, may I walk outside and sit in the garden just to make believe I am normal? I want to belong. I want to be like everybody.
Well, one of the alternatives. Just in the event that this last treatment is not successful. This is simply to allow you to move into a special area in which people of your kind have been congregated.
Congregated? Oh, you mean segregated. You ain't in prison, don't you, Doctor? You're talking about a ghetto, aren't you? A ghetto designed for freaks.
Please take this off me. Please take this off me. Oh, please take this off me. Take it off me. Take it off me.
All right, Miss Tyler. No change. No change at all. Turn on the light.
Now the questions that come to mind. What kind of world where ugliness is the norm and beauty the deviation from that norm? You want an answer? The answer is, it doesn't make any difference. Because the old saying happens to be true. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Lesson to be learned in the Twilight Zone.
In 1964, the Twilight Zone door closed for the last time on network television. In 1968, the highly acclaimed series The Prisoner took science fiction again to the cutting edge. Loaded with surreal symbols and props, the program carries a cult status today, undiminished by time. The Prisoner is a bizarre, puzzling, sometimes confusing, always provocative mind trip. It was the unique vision of Patrick McGoohan who created and starred in The Prisoner. The series is about a secret agent who quits his high security job. The government wants to find out why. A mysterious figure follows him, rendering him unconscious. He awakens in a never-never land called The Village, where the series is played out. Here are highlights from several episodes of The Prisoner. Brace yourself. What you're about to experience is television turned upside down.
Where am I? In the village.
Good morning, all. It's another beautiful day. Your attention, please. Here are two announcements. Ice cream is now on sale for your enjoyment. The flavor of the day is strawberry.
What's it all about?
It's a question of your resignation.
Go on.
The information in your head is priceless. A man like you is worth a great deal on the open market.
I don't know who you are or who you work for. And I don't care. I'm leaving.
Let's make a deal. Tell us what we want to know. This can be a very nice place.
I will not make any deals with you. I've resigned. I will not be pushed, filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered. My life is my own. You won't hold me.
Number 6, heading for outer zone in our vehicle. Orange alert.
Do you still think you can escape, Number 6?
I'm going to do better than that.
Oh.
Going to escape and come back.
Come back?
But only escape, come back, wipe this place off the face of the earth, obliterate it, and you with it.
Don't worry, Number 6. You'll be cured.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty. He had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
This is it. 1 week. Neither of us can leave till death do us part.
Die!
Three.
Die!
Congratulations. We shall need the body for evidence. What do you desire?
Number 1.
I'll take you.
And who is the mysterious Number 1? The ultimate power in this strange world? Patrick McGoohan answered the question in the final episode of The Prisoner, called Fallout.
I will not be pushed, filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered. I will not be pushed, filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered. My life is my own.
So, who is Number 1 in the strange world of The Prisoner? We are. According to Patrick McGoohan's vision, we are the masters of our own fate. Or at least we should be. Coming up, Carrie Fisher with more adventures in outer space. We have engaged the Borg.